In the previous video, we have tried to derive the gravitational potential energy roughly. We first find the work done by gravity in moving the object from infinity to the position of interest. And the work done by gravity, we obtain G, big M, small m, divided by R. We know that gravitational potential energy is just a negative of this expression over here. So if we add a negative in front of this expression, we obtain our gravitational potential energy. So gravitational potential energy is equal to negative g big m small m divided by r. That's the rough derivation that I did in the previous video. So in this video, what I'm going to do is I'm going to derive it step by step, and I'll explain why there's a negative sign here and why this is just related. It's not exactly equal. I'll do everything formally step by step. But before we start the derivation, let's do a bit of recall on how to determine the work done if the force is changing throughout the journey. And I'll be using a slide that I've used from chapter 5. And if you're not sure which video is it, you can refer to the link, which is somewhere up here. Okay, so this is the slide, but I will remove the stuff that are not relevant to me. Okay, so the work done by a force, if this force over here is changing through the journey, we can determine the work done here by finding the area under the F parallel X graph. So the force here might be pointing in any direction, it can be any direction, but if we are finding the area, it must be the area of F parallel X graph. F parallel means by we are finding the component of force that is parallel to X. Okay, so X here is representing position. So if you are moving to this direction, then you go from 0, 0 here is origin, right? So you are starting here. So if you move to the right, then you go to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, something like that. The change of position, position is X. If you are moving, then you experience change of position. And as you change your position, there is a change to the force that you experience when you change your position. Okay, so component of F is this component of F is parallel to X. What am I trying to say here is, for this situation, we see that X should be pointing to the right will be a positive direction, right? If X is pointing to the right, it's a positive direction because it gets 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That means the positive direction for X will be to this direction. If our component of force parallel to X is in the same direction as the direction of X, then we'll get this component to be a positive component. But if our F parallel here is pointing in the opposite direction to X, then what will happen is the component of force parallel to X here will be a negative value. So you appear below the X-axis. So this is important. You need to check whether the component of F parallel to X is in the same direction as the growing X or in the opposite direction to it. If it's opposite, you have to change it to negative. That's the main point I'm trying to deliver. And if you want to find the work done, you have to find the integration of the force parallel through this change of position dx over here. Okay, so let's come back to our slide over here. This is the situation we are analyzing, and we are interested to find the work done in bringing the mass small m here from an initial position to the final position, which is at a distance of r away from big mass m. So if you want to determine the work done, this is what we're going to do. If you want to determine the work done, we have to find the component of force that is parallel to X, right? But this is for chapter 5. If we are in chapter 7 over here, we are measuring in terms of R, right? But R will increase as you get further and further away from big mass M over here. So you need to change this expression to be in terms of R. You are not moving in the x dimension, you are moving, you need to express it in terms of r, where r is a distance away from big mass m here. Okay, if you look at the situation here, r is measured from the center of big mass m over here. If you get further and further away from the big mass m over here, you are getting larger and larger value for r. So you should expect for this graph over here, our R here should be increasing in this direction. So the R here, positive direction of R will be pointing to the right. Based on this diagram, positive should be pointing to the right for R. Okay, and this component of F that is parallel to R is in the direction pointing to the left. Pointing to the left for force, but for R, positive is to the right. That means they are in opposite direction. If they are in opposite direction, you should substitute the F parallel here to be negative value because it's in opposite direction. Therefore, you need to change your graph here. If you change from previously just F, you change it to F parallel, and you need to see whether they are in the same direction or opposite direction. Now, F is in the opposite direction to the increasing R, which is to the right. Therefore, we need to flip our graph to be something like this. You flip the graph vertically. So now you can see that you change this to become negative g big M small m over R squared. And our force will be approaching zero as we move away from big planet and big mass M over here. Okay, so now you see the area is now below the graph already. Okay, so the area is below the graph. So later when you substitute here, it should be a negative here. Okay, this is how we get the negative. It's because the force is opposite the direction of R. Okay, so we get a negative here and we need to substitute our initial R and our final R for the limit, upper lower limit and upper limit of the integration. So now let's proceed and use this equation to determine the work done by gravity and find the gravitational potential energy. So let's move our graph up a bit. So we know that gravitational potential energy is a negative of the work done by gravitational force in bringing mass small m from infinity to that point. So our initial R here will be at the R from the R measured from the big mass m to infinity. And the R initial here should be infinite because they are infinitely far away. That's R initial. But RF here, we know that arrive at the final position, the distance between big mass m and small mass m here is equals to R. So we need to change this to infinite. We need to change this to R. So if we do our gravitational potential energy is equals to the negative of the work done by gravity to go from infinite to the distance R. And if we substitute, we will substitute R initial to be infinite. We will substitute R final to be R because finally our distance will be R. And we just put in negative gmm over R squared and integrate dr. Okay, so first thing is negative g big M small m here are constant. Your mass of these two masses will not change and your g is a constant, it will not change. So you can bring out negative g big M small m out from the integral. Then you get negative g big M small m outside. Then inside the integral is just 1 over r squared. 1 over r squared, if you integrate it, you get negative 1 over r. This is from maths. So you have negative 1 over r inside, then you have upper limit and your lower limit. So now what you continue to do is you substitute your upper limit minus this thing with the lower limit. So you substitute it in, it will become negative 1 over r minus negative 1 over infinity. Minus negative, change it to become positive, so negative 1 over r plus 1 over infinity. When you reach this part here, this part is important because 1 over infinity will be equals to 0. 1 divided by something extremely big will be equals to 0. So this part over here will be equals to 0. Then if you bring everything together, you see that it's equals to negative gmm over r. What's in the big bracket over here is the work done by gravity. And we can see there's a negative here, there's a negative here. So if you multiply it, it'll become positive. Then you have positive g big M small m divided by r in the bracket. And in the bracket is work done by gravity. And as we can see, work done by gravity is positive g big M small m over r. That's what we see in the bracket. But once you multiply by negative because of a negative sign here, you get the gravitational potential energy to be equals to negative g big M small m divided by r. And that's how you derive the equation for gravitational potential energy. You start from a negative work done by gravity in bringing the object from infinity to the position at r away from big mass m. Then you do go through your derivation, which is involving integral. Then you get this equation for your gravitational potential energy. So this is the equation that we will be using when we want to determine the gravitational potential energy of a system.